was a fish observer who found dead on board a Taiwanese tuna fishing vessel in March last year. When he was found dead, he was on his cabin on the floor, face up with blood on his shirt. The cause of death was suspected homicide, but some months later, a second pathologist ruled that Eritrea likely died of natural causes. Their family is worried that the truth might be covered up.
I think there's so much money involved, you know, in the transshipping. I don't think that, you know, Kiribati wants to cause problems with their biggest consumer of their tuna, Taiwan and China. So it's easier to lie and let it just be a mystery to resolve the crime.
This is not an isolated case. Fish observer is in charge of monitor the catch on distant water fishing vessels and report any IUU fishing. When you are sailing at sea, it's very difficult for him to seek help if he is in danger.
When alone at sea, regardless of the laws and regulations, I have to protect myself. It's important. If I have a conflict with him, how can I survive the rest of the days? Impossible. If I report any issues, the coordinator will inform Taiwan's fishery agency, and then the company, and then the captain. Eventually, the captain would know it's me. So why should I report?
那有一次我记得，他让我乘那个快艇去对面那个游龙上记录那个加油的数据。这个工作其实应该是本船的龙机长或者是大管去进行的。我不知道他当时为什么让我去。上船小艇之前他还没给我救生衣，我问他要，他说：“哎呀，没事啊，就这么点距离。”我上扶梯的时候，一脚踩空，一只手挂在那个扶梯上，差点掉在海里。那如果我又不会游泳，那天如果掉在海里的话，估计都没我了。
The result of this investigation hasn't come out yet. So since last March, his family has been waiting for answers of why and how he died on the vessel.